Welcome back. My name is Lucy and I'm a fine art beader. So this is part two in my mini series talking about bead tool. So this is really first steps in using the bead tool. Opening it for the first time, trying to draw some things in bead tool, erasing it, using the flood fill tool, and then saving it. And a little bit later in this video, I'll show you how to open up a pattern that you've already saved from a previous time that you've been using it. So first of all, obviously you need to download the Bead Tool software. So you can either try the trial version, in which case you won't be able to save anything, but you'll be able to get the gist of this. Or if you've got the purchase version, all the functionality will be there. You then need to open your Bead Tool, either from your applications folder or from one of your toolbars on which you might keep the icon for handiness. So let's take a look at the window first. So you have a toolbar down the left hand side and then a set of standard icons across the top. In the middle there is a grid and that's where you're going to create your pattern, and down the right hand side you have the pattern and palette for your pattern that you're going to make. So let's click on the palette first. I happen to have Miyuki Delica's size 11s already selected, but if you click on the drop down, yours will look different to mine because I've already saved some custom palettes. And you can see on there, on your version, you should see a whole range of Miyuki Delicas and rounds in various sizes. Preciosa, Pony, Toho, but I'm going to stick with Miyuki 11s, and that's quite a popular size. Next, go to the pattern, and you can see there's quite a variety to choose from here. You've got square and loom and POT. POT is quite interesting, so you can have a look at the different types of or the drops of POT, all the way up to nine drop. Tubular peyote, I've not actually tried. Raw two bead, and raw three bead. So raw stands for right angled weave. But I'm going to stick with square, keeping life simple. Now at this stage, I'm not going to talk about the exact sizing. I'm going to do that in a different video. But you can see here, we have 55 columns on the grid, which equals 7.458 centimetres, and 39 rows, which equals 6.825 centimetres. Now don't worry if it looks slightly different, you've got slightly different figures in your version, because I might have customised these sizes, I don't think I have. One important tip, and I'm using a Mac here, so don't forget that, so you may see things slightly differently. So in order to change the number of rows or the numbers of columns, you can use the up and down arrows. Alternatively, if you choose to write in the box, let's say you want to go up to 100 columns rather than 55 columns, you don't really want to click the up arrow 45 times. So if you're going to type into that box, always, always follow it up by a return. Okay. I only want 55, so I'll type in 55 and hit return. A feature I use all the time is the zoom, and you'll find that at the top. Now, depending on your setup on your computer, you will either click it once to enlarge the grid and click it again to reduce it, or your roller ball may allow you to zoom with continuous variability. I want it to be zoomed, so I'm clicking it, so we can see things easily. Down the left hand side, I'm really only going to concentrate on three tools. If you hover over the tools, you can see the pencil, the eraser, and the flood fill. Make sure pencil is selected. This is going to draw in the colours onto the grids. And you can see it's selected because you've got a grey around the pencil in the square. Now go to your palette. This is where you select your bead colour. Now, if you know the number, for instance, perhaps I want to use dB 100, which is transparent light. I can first of all start typing 1 and it will find anything with a 1 in the number. If I type 10, anything with 10 turns up. But if we know we want 100, it'll give me all the 100s. So I've selected that. Now I'm going to draw a square on the grid. And you could either click once to fill in individual squares or just click and drag. So I've not done that very well, but have no fear. I'm now going to select the eraser by clicking it. And you've guessed it, I can either click individual cells or I can click and drag to erase the colours. Now I want another colour. This time I'm going to search by colour. So I'm going to delete 100 and type in blue. Any beads described as blue appear. I'm going to go for DB1138, opaque cyan blue. So I've clicked it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill red in between the blue and the gold. So I go back to the palette, search for red, click on the one I want, then click on flood fill. Don't forget to click on flood fill and click in the area that I want to fill. I might as well fill in the centre as well. Now let's go back and look at the pattern. And hey presto, it's collected the colours that I've chosen and also has a bead count. And I find that very, very useful. Now, this is going to blow your mind. I've changed my mind. Square is not going to do it for me. I want peyote. Or perhaps square was a better bet. So I'm going to go back to square. So that's a bit of fun. The asterisk at the top of the window here means that you have edited the pattern. And you need to save it in order to save the changes. So click save and it gets saved into a library. Remember, in the trial version you won't be able to save, so give it a name and description if you've got the purchase version. Going back to the pattern, if I make a mistake, I've flood filled the whole of the grid, I can click undo. Now next I want to show you how to open a pattern that I've previously created using this method. So the key thing to remember here is when you're looking for a saved pattern, you want to go to browse. Okay, browse. And you'll be in patterns and my pattern. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to scroll all the way down to the dog roses. And here I could show you the progression I've done between the versions. So, version 3, you can see in the preview, version 4, version 5. So I think I'm going to pick the latest version, version 5. And if you click on the zoom, you can see the whole pattern. And you can start work again and save it as a new pattern if you want a new pattern or a new version. And that is how you do it. So I hope you've enjoyed that. My name is Lucy. I'm a fine art beader. I paint with beads. So please subscribe, share, like, tell all your friends, and do come back to see the next part in this mini series on BeadTool, which will be all about importing images and pictures and creating a bead pattern from those. So see you soon.